Okay, so this project is basically about building your own lithium cell capacity tester. So basically you pop in any 18650 cell into this device and it will calculate the capacity and display it on the OLED display over here. But why do you need one? Because you can't always trust the capacity values mentioned on these cells. Here, take a look at this. This box of 18650 cells claims to have a capacity of 6000 mAh per cell, which is a complete BS. Apart from finding these fake cells, you will also need a capacity tester when you're building bigger battery packs, like this one. So this is a 24 volt 20 Ah battery pack, and here when you're building bigger battery packs like this one, you have to check the capacity of each cells to make sure everything is in the same level. Normally what people do in industries is they use something called a cell grading machine, which checks the charging and discharging performance at each cell before it is used in a pack. But here we'll be building a very crude and miniature version of it, which you can use in a project. Interesting, right? So let's get started. Before we get started, let's take a quick look at DigiKey Electronics, who is not only the sponsors for this video, but are also the suppliers for all electronic components used in this project. DigiKey provides more than 13.4 million components from over 2,300 quality name brand manufacturers, with products in stock available for immediate shipment. DigiKey can also act as your one-stop shop for all your electronic components need. Also, with their fast shipping and excellent customer service, you can trust that the components will always arrive on time and in top condition. So do remember to check digikey.in for your next project. Now the main idea here is to take an 18650 cell, use a charging IC to charge the cell to the maximum voltage, which is 4.2 volt for NMC cells. And once charged, we can then connect the cell to a MOSFET and a shunt resistor. Now by turning on the MOSFET, the cell will start to discharge. But our aim here is to calculate the capacity of these cells, and in order to do that, we have to discharge them at a constant current. So to do that, we will use a microcontroller to sense the current and generate a PWM signal to drive the MOSFET. During this constant current discharge, the microcontroller will calculate the capacity of the cell and display it on a OLED screen. Now, the microcontroller used here is the famous Atmega328P from your Arduino boards, and the charger IC is the MAX1898, and the op amp is the AD8542, both of which are from analog devices. Now that we have a basic understanding, let's take a look at the circuit diagram for this project. So here is the complete circuit diagram for our project, and you can also see the hardware over here so that we can compare the circuit diagram with the actual hardware. In fact, I will remove the OLED display over here so that you can actually see the complete PCB board. So on the circuit diagram, let's start with the leftmost corner, which is the microcontroller section. And as you can see here, we have used the Atmega328 microcontroller, which is on the board over here, along with all its auxiliary components. The A16 megahertz crystal oscillator, external crystal oscillator, can be found here, is used to clock the microcontroller. And apart from that, we have also used the ICSP header pins, which you can see here, to program this microcontroller using the MISO, MOSI, SEK, and the reset pins, which are connected to the microcontroller over here. Then apart from this, there are nothing major with the microcontroller section. We have indicator LED, which we can use to check what's happening with the microcontroller for debugging and all those stuff. Then we have some filter capacitors, and that's pretty much it on the microcontroller side. Moving on, we have the switches and the display side. You can see three switches over here, key 1, key 2, key 3, connected to the microcontroller. So basically what we'll be doing is we'll be using three modes on our discharging device. One is to charge the cell, another is to discharge the cell, and the third one is to check the capacity of the cell. And we also had an OLED display, which we just removed, which speaks with this SDA and SEL lines to our microcontroller over here. You can see the SDA and SEL connected here. Now that is all with the switch and the OLED section. The most important thing in this circuit diagram is the charger section and the load section. So what happens is, once you connect an 18650 cell over here, we will first enable the charging process by pressing on this button. And the charging process is taken
care by this Max 1898 charging IC from Analog Devices. Now this IC was purchased from DigiKey.in. As you can see on the product page, you can see the price, data sheet and other information about this IC. You can see the IC on our board over here. It requires very few auxiliary components to make the IC work. So what we have done is we have connected it to a micro USB, which you can see here, which provides 5 volt for the IC to operate. And basically this IC monitors the cell voltage, charges it and monitors the charging voltage as the cell gets charged. And once it reaches 4.2, it automatically stops the charging. Now we can use this resistor R9 to set the charging current. For this example, we have used a resistor value to set the charging current to 1 amps, but you can change the resistor value and set the charging current less than 1 amps if you need. The maximum current for charging with this IC is 1 amps. Now that is all with the charging section. Once the charging is done, it will automatically cut off and it will stop the charging process. And then we can press on button 2, which will start the discharging process. Now for discharging to happen, we have this circuitry over here, which consists of a MOSFET. Let me just zoom in. So yeah, for the discharging to happen, what we have done is we have connected the battery to a MOSFET and a shunt resistor. Now you can see the MOSFET, which is the IRF540N over here with the heatsink, and you can also see the shunt resistor, which is a 1 ohm 10 watt shunt resistor. So basically during the discharge process, the electrical energy from the cell will be converted to heat energy dissipating over the shunt resistor and this MOSFET. Now to control the current that is being discharged, we'll be measuring the current which is being discharged through this MOSFET and the shunt resistor using this current sense pin, and we will also be measuring the cell voltage to make sure we are not discharging the cell below the permissible value, which is 3.2 volts for NMC cells. So based on this current which is being discharged, the microcontroller measures both the voltage using the Vsense pin and the current using the Csense pin, and based on the discharge current, it will produce a PWM signal of varying duty cycle, which will be used to trigger the MOSFET. As you can see, the PWM signal goes through an op amp and then reaches the MOSFET.
Again, the op amp used here is the AD8542, which you can see over here. And we also purchased this from DigiKey as shown here on the product page.
So this PWM signal reaches the MOSFET, and based on the current, the PWM signal duty cycle changes, and hence the current through the current that is discharged through the cell is also controlled. So for our example, we have set the discharge current to 700 milliamps, but you can set it up to 1 amps or even less than that based on your preference. So that is it. Once a cell starts discharging in a constant current, it is very easy for us to calculate the capacity. We just have to see how long that cell is able to discharge in that constant current till it reaches an under voltage cutoff of 3.2 volt. So in the program side, basically we will be discharging the cell, monitor the current, monitor the voltage during the discharge process, calculate the capacity as a running average, and then once the cell reaches 3.2, stop the discharging process and display the total capacity on our OLED screen, which is connected over here. So that is it, guys. This is pretty much about the hardware. There is nothing much complicated over here. So once the circuit diagram is ready, all we had to do was convert the circuit diagram into a Gerber file and get the PCBs ready. So this is the top layer and the bottom layer of the PCB design which we have used.
Now to keep things visually appealing, we tried the orange color masking on our PCB boards. But here, take a look at it. I am not sure if I really like it, but what do you think? By the time our PCB boards arrived, we also received all the required components for our project from DigiKey. Like always, the packaging was professional and all items were neatly labeled, so we just began assembling our board. Within few minutes, we assembled all the components and our board was ready for programming. Now, we are not going to get into the depths of the programming for the matter of this video. Just upload the code into your Atmega IC here and you're good to go.
Now, the board here is ready. Let me just turn it on. As you can see, it says capacity cell tester, and then it gives three options for us. One is to charge the cell, second is to test the capacity, and the third is to check the cell voltage. Now before we do any of that, let me take a 18650 cell and we can insert it into the slot over here and we can begin testing the cell. Okay, now we have the cell inserted into our 18650 cell holder here, and it is connected. The positive of the cell is connected to this pin and the negative of the cell is connected to this pin. So before we do anything, let's first check the cell voltage. We can press the third button and you can see that the current cell voltage is around 3.7, which is normally the voltage it will be when you receive it from a factory. So what we can do is we can first charge the cell by pressing on the first button. And as you can see, the charging process has already started. You can see this animation, and with time you can slowly see the voltage of the cell increasing. Now let us leave it to it. Let's come back after some time and see if the cell is fully charged. Now it has been some time, and as you can see, the cell has slightly charged to around 3.9 volt. Ideally it should charge up to 4.2 volt and it should cut off on its own, but for the sake of this video, let's proceed with discharging the cell as well. So this button here discharges the cell. So as you can see, the discharging process has started, and we have set 500 milliamps to be our discharging current. As you can see, the current is currently increasing based on how much the MOSFET is closed, and once it reaches 500 milliamps, as you can see here, the microcontroller adjusts the PWM signal and maintains the discharge current at around 500 milliamps. Now while that is happening, you can also see the capacity is also being calculated. Right now it is 4 mAh, and you can also see the voltage is being monitored. Once the voltage reaches 3.2 volt, the final capacity will be displayed here. So that is it, very simple working over here, and this is how you can test the capacity of the cells.
With that, we have come to a conclusion for this video. If you like what you saw, do consider subscribing to this channel and also throw us a like. With that, this is me, Ashwin, fading out. Have a nice day. Bye bye. Take care.